the crowd are loving it. Rui has to be very careful, just effortlessly just moved out of range and kick. And again, really great economy of effort from Botelho. And he comes in range with a left and a right, short punches. We'll have a blow there from Superlek. What a nice start, Mitch.
Superlek is coming with a lot more heat than we've seen in straight matches in the past.
Oh, back punch! Overhand right, just as Botelho just tried to shorten the distance. It landed quite high up in the head, but it dropped him instantly. Three knockdowns in one round equals a technical knockout, so watch for that with 2:13 left in this opener.
See, Superlek starting to bring the heat. Botelho, this is what Botelho's got to do. He's got to make it dirty. He can't stand a range, especially kicking range.
Referee Olivier Costa just making sure that clinch doesn't go on for too long. It's all action here. Right hand from Botelho was a nice one as Superlek was coming in. Flying knee. Huge noise from the crowd behind me here in Bangkok. Just grabbed that foot, looked for a colossal right hand. Botelho ducked underneath it.
See how well Superlek is using the fence. He's able to back Botelho up because Botelho's not circling out. He can't allow Superlek to come in like this.
Botelho holding all he can there. Superlek unleashing a great effort and straight back into it as Olivia Costa brings them together. Right hand, nice short punch from Superlek.
And he's parrying down the lead hand. Botelho with his lead hand, he's swapping down the hand. That's what's going to circle around and land that big right hand.
This is so intense from Superlek. You get the feeling that Botelho is just being a little bit reactionary, just looking at what's going to happen and see if he can counter. It's certainly Superlek that is leading the action. Just has a little brush of his right eye there to see if he's been marked.
Nice, the right hand landed by Botelho. That's what he needs more of. He needs to close that distance and throw those hands.
These two are just not holding back. 35 seconds left in this opening round. It's been wonderful action. Looking for the spinning back elbow there, Botelho. Charging in with the kick to the head. Back in the center of the circle now. 24 seconds left. The right hand from Superlek comes back. But his leg is held. And they go down to the mat. And Superlek landed quite heavily. Botelho landed on top of him. So a little bit of a warning there from Olivier Costa. 10 seconds left in this opening round. It's been all action. Super stuff.
Good job by Botelho to get that leg up and check that right kick. That's what he needs more of. Now they have to adjust their style of defense to complement the little gloves.
Punishing, pushing Botelho back. Right hand as well, followed up with a foot. Every strike he throws is being cheered by the home fans here. Botelho battling not only his opponent, but the entire Impact Arena, seemingly. Botelho just looking over his shoulder, trying to take a little bit of advice from his corner man. They know everything about this sport. The fans here at the Impact Arena, Muay Thai is their bread and butter, and they are really enjoying this. Hope you can hear their cheers at home every time something is thrown. And it's good work from Superlek, isn't it? Knees to the side of the body, answered by Botelho.
Botelho's shown some good eyes. He's been able to evade a lot of the big kicks thrown by Superlek, and then Superlek actually starts kicking at the hip. So instead of Botelho moving out of the way, those hips don't move, and he starts attacking the leg of Botelho.
Now, as Botelho's leg was caught and he went down, Superlek looked for a kick as he was falling, and Olivier Costa just giving him a little warning there that that's not quite the done thing.
Botelho's tough. It's that body kick. It's forward, there's a big right hook.
Olivier Costa is working almost as hard as these two athletes. 1:21 left of the second round. The left hand, it was a chopping left hand. Just wanted to brush the face of Superlek.
And then that elbow came answering right back to Superlek. Narrowly missed that left hand, but then just stepped in.
left of the second round. The action continues to be relentless. Left, right from Botelho. Not cleanly landed, though. Superlek ushers him in. Says, come on, let's have a battle here in the center of the circle.
Botelho can't get sucked into that game. He's got to keep moving.
Botelho gets pushed back to the circle wall there with a super kick to the center of the body.
Superlek's trying to egg him on, and Botelho's answering, but he's got to move. He cannot just play this game with Superlek.
30 seconds left for the second round. Everything into that kick, but it was parried by Botelho. He's enjoying this, isn't he? The tie. Big right hand just crushes the jaw. Just gets a little bit untidy. Dying moments of this second round. A Muay Thai contest for us all to enjoy here. Bangkok, Thailand. The fans enjoying the final moments as Superlek goes to war again with that right leg. Ragdolls his man to the ground. There's a little bit of tension between these two. His opponent, Superlek in the right, and again he goes up high with the leg and then comes downstairs to the ribcage. And again he's beckoning Botelho in. Just teasing him, annoying him. Oh, what a wonderful kick that went to the jaw. Follows it up with another one, and Botelho might be in a bit of trouble here. The elbow to the head as well. Superlek's leg gets held. The action in the first 30 seconds of this round has been intense. Kick to the waist there from Superlek. Damaging sort of teak kick above the knee that can hyperextend it. Also clearly in his arsenal. Has a little shake of the head there, Superlek. Not quite going the way he wants it to. He's got just over 2 minutes to give this crowd a spectacular finish.
Good balance by Superlek. As Botelho had his leg elevated, tried to sweep out, but he was the one that ended up down. Superb balance shown by Superlek.
Good work to the body from the Portuguese, couple of left hands. Nice and low to the ribcage. Earning the respect of Superlek, who's teased him at times. Power of that kick, and now Botelho. Now Botelho gives him a little smile and a nod and extends the hand of friendship, the sportsmanship that we see so often in the World Championship Circle. Good right hand from Superlek, landed flush on the jaw. 1:20 left of this third and final round.
So those kicks are landing to the hip of Botelho because he's got good eyes. He's moving out of the way of the head kick. So Superlek's attacking that right, left side of the body and the hip of Botelho.
Which he occasionally does, he is very vulnerable to a sharp counter from the top. Olivia Cost really has had a workout in this one. Once again, sportsmanship on show, 45 seconds left. Elbow coming in from Superlek, and it landed. And a bit of a clinch there on the circle wall.
The way Superlek comes in, gains those distance with those elbows, and they come from a lot of different angles, Steve.
Just wanted to remark upon the sportsmanship again there, Mitch. It's been fiercely contested, this one, but in the spirit that we so commonly see in one championship. And once again, Superlek just has a little paw at that eye to see if there's been any damage done. It's clearly bothering him a little bit. So Botelho knows he's done some damage. Is it enough, though, when the judges?
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Superlek Kiatmoo9.
Many good luck charms used in Muay Thai. Very superstitious martial art that dates back thousands of years. This one, though, under kickboxing rules, the elbows and the extent of the knees will not be permitted here. A groin strike early on, accidental to Masahide Kudo. But Kudo is okay to continue here. Straight back on the action. southpaw stance on Panpayak Jitmuangnon. Jab there from Panpayak. Nice high lift roundhouse kick from the Thai. Good thread jab from Panpayak. Body head goes Kudo. You'll need to rely on the speed here, Masahiro Kudo. Try and fluster Panpayak with the combinations. Panpayak will rely more on their single strikes, loaded with power. They clinch up in tango and referee Oda breaks them. Front bridge and left hand there, 4 ounce gloves in use for this one. No margin for error when you're using 4 ounce gloves. Good popping right hand there, being the jab off the southpaw of Panpayak, Jitmuangnon.
Kudo's trying to reach out, he's trying to paw that lead hand of Panpayak. He's having a hard time with the range of Panpayak. Narrowly missed with that big left kick.
Go! Just a warning there from referee Onari. Front kick for Panpayak. Kudo trying to get on the inside. Panpayak sticks out the jab. Quickly high lift roundhouse kick. Going for the headache maker. Inside leg kick there from Panpayak. It just drains the cup again of Kudo. Perhaps that's a lower that inside leg kick. Often a problem when competing as a southpaw. I'd like to go for the inside leap thigh, and it can often lead to groin strikes, unintentionally, of course. It is one of the side effects of competing against the southpaw. Stiff left hand there, being the rear hand of Panpayak. You could see in his mind, it was ticking over. Kickboxing rules, you can't throw the elbows.
Beautiful push
kick. Himself back up after that push kick. It was very nicely placed, Mitch.
The timing was absolutely excellent. Just taking Kudo up off his feet.
Jab working well for Panpayak so far. Kudo again gets to the inside and gets punished with the left cross. Couple forearm guard against the round kick. Panpayak looking very relaxed, moving well. Jabbing off the back foot when he does drift backwards.
Kudo's having a real hard time with the range of Panpayak. Every time he enters into Pompeyak's just sort of his zone, he's getting lit up.
Round kick again from Panpayak, got power. Not getting through the forearm though, but breaking down the forearm of Masahiro Kudo. What the Muay Thai athletes love to do. They'll kick away over and over again the forearm, that uterus, until the opponent drops the arm. Then they can power over the top. Three judges are ringside. They are scoring on a 10-point must system. Winner of the round gets 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. Nicely placed there from Panpayak. Just a warning, if you're going to clinch up, you can only do so for a few seconds. You've got to stay easy in the clinch and throw the beans. Otherwise, the referee will break you under these kickboxing rules.
See, Kudo's trying to enter into the range, but he's dropping his head down, which is sort of a dangerous move to do, especially with Panpayak. He's got excellent timing. You might see him meet a knee here. You watch him come in right there, drop his head down a little bit. It's lit up there.
That left roundhouse kick is coming agonizingly close to the back of the neck of Masahiro Kudo. Caution to watch the balls with the head. A beautiful push kick there from Panpayak up against Kudo for the second time. Kudo comes forward, throws to the inside leg, forearms up against the round kick again. Chance for the knees, Panpayak doesn't throw them. Referee Onari breaks. Round kick once more, smashes into the right forearm of Kudo. There's the stinging left cross. Kudo gets caught with a jab. There's a jab off the back foot from Panpayak. Having no trouble adjusting to the kickboxing game so far, Panpayak Jitmuangnon, a multiple Muay Thai world champion. Circling clockwise is Kudo, staying away from the power side of Panpayak. Looping left hand from Kudo, almost left himself exposed. Maybe some frustration creeping in here, Mitchell Masahiro Kudo. Beautiful left hand there from Panpayak. You can see the damage on the right eye of Kudo. That left hand of Panpayak has caused some welts on the cheekbone of Masahiro Kudo. High kick again from Panpayak. There's another drilling left hand. Panpayak on fire here in the second. and Kudo has no answer.
You see, Kudo's just kind of, he's really frustrated here. Every time he comes forward, gets into the range of Panpayak, he gets touched up for his trouble. You can see how big Panpayak is able to compete off his back foot. Watch how he strikes off his back foot. It's just an absolute thing of beauty. Looking at that right jab, consistently touching Kudo.
Front kick from Panpayak. Kudo ties him up. Chance for the knees, doesn't throw any. 20 seconds remains. Good jab again from Panpayak. More jabs than a pin cushion for the tie in these two rounds. Whipping round kick. You feel at some stage he's going to connect with that shin to the side of the neck. Hit the carotid artery. Body shot from Kudo. Locks him against the ropes. Referee Onari breaks them. It will go into the third and final round of this one. And Panpayak seems to be in control. Get on the inside, he needs speed, he needs quarter angle turns, he needs lateral footwork. He tries for a hook, he gets tagged with the jab. And here comes the round kicks again from Panpayak. There's the cross from Panpayak. And the round kick once more. Breaking down the forearm of Kudo. Kudo trying to pin him against the ropes, and Panpayak spins him around wisely. Kudo's got a cut to the side of the left eye. Maybe a jab that he ate off the right hand of Panpayak. There's another jab, and Kudo backs him off with a right cross. Panpayak on the outside. Kudo ties him up, chance for the knees. Referee Onari gives him a slap and breaks them. Panpayak resets. Forehand blocks. The power of the hand, the power of those shins. Kudo eats another jab. Roundhouse kick from Panpayak. The Muay Thai roundhouse kick can travel at 135 miles an hour, 209 kilometers an hour. It is a ferocious martial arts weapon. Imagine the impact of a Muay Thai premier Rachlemurd world champion's roundhouse kicks cracking away your ribs, coming for your neck, cracking away your forearms. It's scary.
You can see, but Kudo's not fazed by it. He continually pushes forward, even though he's running damage on his face. He's actually been able to land that right hand a few times in this round. Job of maintaining his distance, keeping Kudo in exactly the range he wants.
Nice jab, little turn off the ropes there from Panpayak. Now he's looking like a kickboxer. He's moving, and he's jabbing. Beautiful evasion from Panpayak. But a palm heel strike there. Kudo eats another jab. That lead hand of Panpayak Jitmuangnon has been an absolute threat. Time and time again here, slipped through the defenses of Kudo. And Kudo's had no comeback. It is punching without payment. Kudo skips forward, eats the jab once more, and Panpayak digs away to the rib cage, left side of the carcass. Look at Panpayak, high on the balls of his feet, oozing with confidence. Nice evasion, slips to the outside. Double jab, catches him on the chin. There's the round kick while he was moving backwards. Very hard to throw. Drifts back to centering now, Panpayak. Skips out of the way of the jab of Kudo. Panpayak off the ropes. Front kick, body shot there from Kudo. Referee Onari breaks them. 30 seconds remaining here, Dragon. Third and final round.
That jab is a thing of beauty coming from Panpayak. That's able to do all the damage to the side of the face there. And that push kick is something true. It's a special treat, too. But that's what Kudo needs to do. He needs to get close, let those hands go.
Panpayak having work with Kudo here. They go to the fight booth now. Look at the respect between these two men.
A unanimous decision from the red corner, Panpayak Jitmuangnon.
Inside the massive Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand. Muay Thai in four-ounce gloves. It doesn't get any better than this. Roundhouse kicks early from Superlek. He's going straight after Lau Chitra. High right roundhouse kick from Superlek. Kiatmoo9. Jumping roundhouse kick from the Thai. A three-time world champion. House on fire.
start breaking down the body and go up top.
Now Chopra has reach in the arms. He's got to use it. He's got to keep Superlek at bay. Inside thigh kick there from the Kuntabai champion. Superlek goes downstairs. Control and center in. Tracks away with the right leg again. That's under nicely done. Now Chopra applies a clinch. Superlek gets a knee off to the ribs. And referee, oh, now he breaks them. What a start here from the three-time world champion, Superlek. That's under the kick again. Hands low, now lifts them, high on the balls of his feet. Cracks away with that roundhouse kick, step through knee there from Superlek. He is pulling out all the weapons, all the eight weapons of Muay Thai here in the first round.
Go! You can see Lao Tetra is having a hard time with the speed. I don't think he's used to starting this fast. Superlek is not following the Muay Thai rule set. He is going right after him in the first round.
Because mid-round here, this is one super series, it's only three rounds. You can't take a filling out process in the first and second. It's all about action, it's all about knockout. And that's what Superlek's looking for here in the opening stanza.
He is, and that's what, and you can see that Lao Tetra is having a hard time. He can't get into the clinch, he can't utilize those elbows. There it is, now he's trying to fire the elbows.
A two-time Kuntabai world champion in the white trunks. Finding the get-go very hard in the opening round here against a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Right hand down the tube there from Superlek, then goes to the break basket. Planting right hand from Superlek. Now Chetra ties him up, chunk for the knees, chunk for the elbow. Knee there from Lao Chetra, downward elbow, hoping for the collarbone. Superlek just all over it. Advances up to his screen as the world champion to see how much time's left in the round.
Interesting clinch game from Superlek. He's utilizing the outside over underhooks to get this because he's not trying to swim in and get inside control. He's very comfortable staying on the outside and using the defensive strategy so he can create openings and throw elbows and knees of his own.
Go!
A tremendous start from Superlek Kiatmoangnon. 2012 Sports Authority of Thailand, Muay Thai Fighter of the Year, three-time world champion.
Round two.
Go.
Have 110 world champion martial artists here at one championship. And you see one of them here, Superlek, with a kicking arsenal. More kick than a porous line for Superlek here in the second round. And here come the hands.
Wow, it was like the first round. Yeah. Was going kind of slow because that was 10 unanswered kicks from Lao Tetra by Superlek.
Like that 11. And there's 12 and there's 13. That right leg is devastating. Here comes the power from Superlek Kiatmoangnon. Front kick to the midsection. Overhand elbow from Lao Tetra. Trying to get on the inside. And now Superlek ties him up against the ropes. A little slap and a tingle there from Atsushionaru. And he breaks them. Look at the defense on the way in from Superlek. Cracks him over the forearms. That one goes down to the waist. That one goes down to the legs. It is all the right leg of Superlek here in the second round. Goes to the body, belly button through the back. Short elbow on the inside there from Lao Chetra.
Needs more of that straight left hand or that right hand. He needs to put that jab out there. Every time Superlek throws a kick, he's got to answer it. He's got to come back.
High kicks again from Superlek, breaking down the forearms of Lao Chetra. Digs the toes into the midsection. Lao needs to use that reach. High kick there from the Cambodian. The three-time Muay Thai champion in the red and blue, Superlek Kiatmoangnon, doing a number here in the second. Snakes the arms around the back of the neck, drills it into the midsection. Now no chance to get off the elbows. Referee, oh no, separates them. It is all out action in one super series. This is Muay Thai with four out gloves. This is the most electrifying martial arts stand-up in the world in 4 ounce gloves. And it's awesome with so much.
It is. And then what is awesome is that right kick from Superlek. He's thrown more right kicks than he has punches in this second round. Look at it, he just keeps hammering the body, the legs, the head.
He got put on by Superlek. Tango against the ropes and referee. Oh, now he breaks them. Final seconds of what has been a cracking second stanza for the three-time Muay Thai world champion, Superlek. And again with the right. Body shot there. Behind the balls of his feet, Superlek. Dancing, grooving, oozing confidence from every pore. And there's going to be a lot of work for Mao Chapnap to do in the final round. Third and final round. It's been one-way traffic, and all the traffic has come via that right leg, the right shin of Superlek Kiatmoo9.
And the whole left side of Mao Chapnap's body is a completely different shade than the right side of his body.
It looks like it's been sunburned. It's reddened the entire carcass and the legs of Mao Chapnap. And Superlek sets the right leg again, boom, to the midsection. Mao Chapnap backs him up, tries for a flying knee to no avail. Chucks the elbows off the right here. And referee Onari breaks it.
We're seeing incredible offensive strategy from Superlek. But we're seeing defense as well. We're seeing a very pinpoint, accurate defensive strategy from Superlek. And that's what's made Mao Chapnap so frustrated with. He's not able to do anything. We just saw it as he was trying to jump in for that knee. Just a little subtle adjustment from Superlek, and he was able to stop the jump. It's very impressive.
You're seeing the skill, the poise, the speed, and the scintillating power that has made Superlek Kiatmoo9 a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Cracks away again with the right roundhouse kick. That shin has done incredible damage. Knee guard put on here by Superlek. And referee Onari separates both these warriors. Two tremendous athletes, two world champions. Southpaw stance on the Cambodian. His inside leg is a shade of purple, a kaleidoscope of colors. The crowd are counting the kicks from Superlek. And they spill to the canvas. Nice dump there from Superlek Kiatmoo9. Slow to pick himself up. Here's Mao Chapnap. 1:05 remaining. Three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system. And you figure they must have given the first round 10-9, the second round 10-9 to Superlek, the three-time world Muay Thai champion. Superlek winds up the roundhouse kick again, gets out of the way of the elbow. A nice low check there from Superlek. Winds up the right again, here it comes, there it goes to the body, doubles up on it. Overhand elbow from Mao Chapnap, downward elbow! And he's impressed with the elbow of Kiatmoo9.
That's what Mao Chapnap said he wanted to do. He wanted to close that distance and start dropping those elbows. He's able to do it in the last 30 seconds of the match.
There's a very special lady we're going to show you here in a moment who is screaming amongst our super fans here ringside. I'll tell you who she is in a few seconds' time, but she is going bananas for someone in the ring right now. Jumping knee from Mao Chapnap! Hoping for a Hail Mary shot, hoping for one big salvo to turn the tide, but it's not going to come. It's going to be Superlek victory here in Bangkok.
A unanimous decision from the red corner, Superlek Kiatmoo9.
Panpayak in the glittering gold. In southpaw starts, he opens up the front kick and then a high left roundhouse kick. Watch for the excellence of execution in everything that Panpayak does. Step through knee, left cross from the tie. Botelho's got to find a way to get on the inside, get within range, get through the reach and go to the jaw, go to the liver, go to the ribs of Panpayak. He's got to guard up against that left roundhouse kick.
That guard high, but he's also got to start circling. He's got to start circling to his left to avoid that big left roundhouse kick.
Panpayak is patient. Cracks away to the inside lead by the Portuguese. Botelho tests the waters downstairs. Needs the right hand for company. Double forearms guard against that left roundhouse kick. Botelho far too flat-footed at the moment. He's got to move. He's got to start drifting to his left.
Standing right in front of Panpayak. He's got to start moving, put those hands in, closing that distance. He's right in the perfect zone. That left kick.
That no man's land. In range for everything. Panpayak wants to throw it in. He throws a left hand down the center corridor. Panpayak, patience. Very light on the lead leg, tricks away with that back leg again. That fabled, that feared left roundhouse kick with Panpayak Jitmuangnon. Front kick for the midsection, digs into the belly button. There's one to the top of the leg. Roundhouse kick again from Panpayak. Nice right hand lever from Botelho, that's more like it from the Portuguese athlete. Roundhouse kick slapped into the lower ribs there, off the left from Panpayak. First time in these 4 ounce gloves.
You know, the 4 ounce gloves change a lot of things. You know, they change the defense, they change, you know, how you're gonna counter, how you're gonna move in. You know, you gotta be very careful, but it also makes the clinch very effective, and it also adds a whole new element of power to the game.
Botelho's dead, he studied tape, a lot of tape of Panpayak, and he said that in what he'd studied and having seen Panpayak get knocked out before, that Panpayak does a little lift often before he kicks. And if he can time Panpayak on that lift, Botelho may be able to connect, maybe with a roundhouse kick of his own. But being quite the shorter here, it will take a phenomenal effort to loop the roundhouse kick around the back of Panpayak's neck.
Now that you mention it, you can start to see it. It's like a slight skip with his lead foot when he sets up that big roundhouse kick. It's a slight little step to initiate a little bit more power.
Round two.
Go!
Something I've never seen before. Panpayak's trainer has his monocle around his neck. Now, it's usually on a ring post. There are no ring posts here with the cage, however, but I hope in a very superstitious martial art that does not bring Panpayak any bad luck. Probing the leg kicks here, Rui Botelho, forearms guard against the high left roundhouse. Goes for the inside thigh, nice and high to that femoral profunda with Panpayak. Botelho in the traditional Portuguese colours, the green and red.
Botelho looks very effective when he's moving forward. When he starts throwing those hands, he closes the distance quick, but he's also getting caught with a little bit of a left hook by Panpayak.
Botelho landed a good combination a few moments ago that should give him some more confidence. Goes forward again. A cracking roundhouse kick from Panpayak came agonizingly close. Botelho fires out a front kick off the back leg. Panpayak left drop down the center. Body kick from the Thai. Roundhouse kick upstairs again. Botelho sees them coming. It's one of those wicked roundhouse kicks like down or like Yodson fly. It could do so much damage. Fake there from Panpayak. Goes upstairs again, just breaking down that right arm of Rui Botelho. There's only so many kicks Botelho can take to that right forearm before the arm drops, and then we'll see if Panpayak can come over the top with a big kibosh.
I'd like to see Panpayak start going to the body of Botelho more. Get him to start protecting that rib, that right side of his body with the elbow, and then he can start working his way up to the head. Botello's okay to take those on the arm.
Botelho unloading on Panpayak for a moment, and the crowd rallied behind the Portuguese star. Under a minute remaining, second round of three. Three judges are scoring on a 10-point must system. You give the winning boxer 10 points, the less dominant boxer 9 points. Oh, there's the big roundhouse kick! Botelho's on rubber legs, he goes down!
5, 6, 7, 8!
Botelho's up in the count at 7. Panpayak gonna finish the Portuguese warrior. This place goes bananas.
Botelho's got to start moving. He doesn't want to stand there. He doesn't want to stand in front of
Panpayak. Here comes Panpayak. Is he gonna finish? A left hand.
measuring. He might let Botelho off the hook here and let him out of this round.
Atsushi Onari gets us up the way, third round. The crowd wants to see a big knockout. Panpayak came close to it with that roundhouse kick in the second stanza. What a weapon, what ferocity.
Botelho needs to glue that right hand to the side of his head. He says he was going to circle left, but he's still standing right in the pocket. Intent to trade with Panpayak. It's a recipe for disaster, though.
Botelho has not adhered to the game plan he said he would. Big front kick there from Panpayak. There's the high kick again. He's got more kick than a drowning horse, has Panpayak. Botelho puts it on the inside. Catches the kick again. Tries for a left hook.
That's his combination. He goes through that push kick with the lead leg, with the lead right leg, and then he comes over top with that right left roundhouse kick. He faked it, and that's what caught Botelho. He was expecting the push kick to come in, but he faked it, lifting up his left right foot and coming over the top of the left kick.
Go!
Panpayak looks fresh. Not a drop of sweat on him. Not a bruise, not a scratch. He has been dominant in his one Super Series debut. And that left roundhouse kick has been something extraordinary to behold. Inside leg kick from Botelho. Probing with the jab, the Portuguese. Got to go to his left. He continues to wear these roundhouse kicks. That one was dropped to the ribcage. 1 minute 20 remains. Panpayak sends him 5 paces back with a front kick to the solar plexus.
Those push kicks that are setting up that left roundhouse kick, it comes from the front with the lead leg, and it's also coming from the back. It's both an offensive and defensive weapon.
Oh, he knocks him! The left hand! Referee Onari says no knockdown, but that was a beautiful left hand from Botelho.
So give Botelho some confidence. He needs to take advantage of that.
No knockdown, says the referee. Can Botelho capitalize, though? That left hand's been his best weapon, the little man from Portugal.
You hear the cracking sound of that left kick is landing on the right hand of Botelho.
Stop. And the clinch here, no knees exchange. Referee, oh, no, gracious. Nice, Botelho. We've got another one of those left hooks in the final 25 seconds. Left hook, right hand, the old 3-2 combination there from the Portuguese. Botelho's got a swing, and he's got a swing now. Final 10 seconds. It'll be a decision win for Panpayak unless Botelho can find a Hail Mary left hook here. So first kick from Panpayak.
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Panpayak
Jitmuangnon. This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.